Let's go through an example, start to finish with new data and evaluating correlation and this coefficient of determination. So what we have here is this data for airfare and distance when traveling away from Baltimore, Maryland. So in that first column, they're describing the distance away. Second column, they're describing the airfare, and they tell us the destination where they're heading. So first, let's figure out what's our explanatory variable, which explanatory is the one that explains change, and that's going to relate to x since that's independent. And then there's going to be the response variable that's responding to that explanatory variable, so that's going to be the thing that changes. So it's going to be our dependent variable y. Now if we just kind of play around with the wording here, is it going to be that distance explains change in airfare, or is it going to be that airfare explains change in distance? And you can kind of think about like which occurs first in terms of a sequence. Do you determine the airfare first, or do you determine the distance you're traveling first? And typically it's that you'd know where you're traveling, or you know how far you're traveling first, and then airfare adjusts to how far you're traveling. Like typically if you're not going very far, you don't pay that much. And then if you're going to fly internationally, those ticket costs go up. So what's going to be responding is airfare. And distance is going to be our explanatory variable. So we'll have this first column is x, second column is y. So that'll help us when we get to GeoGebra and plugging in our data for finding r and our scatter plot. So in part B, create a scatter plot for the data using technology. We're going to use GeoGebra. And do we pass the conditions? Which basically means, is the data roughly linear? And are there any clear outliers or groupings that we need to be careful of? So if we go to GeoGebra, I already input our data. Make sure you put whatever's your explanatory variable in column A, and then column B is the response variable. And then we'll want to highlight our data. Then we go to that histogram picture, but we want to choose the scatter plot for our two-variable regression analysis. That'll give us a scatter plot. This looks roughly linear. We can imagine a line going through that data. There's a potential outlier up here, but it's not completely disconnected from everything. So we'll just make a mental note, and actually we'll investigate that point later on in the videos. But for right now, nothing's too far skewed away, no clear groupings. So we're gonna be good here. So for our conditions, do we pass the conditions? Yes. The data is roughly linear. So then we could go on and figure out what is the correlation between the airfare and the distance of the flight. So they just want to know what is the correlation. We just want to find what is R. So with that in GeoGebra, we would just click our summation X symbol in that upper right hand corner. And that should open up our statistics. And we just want to grab this value for R, which is a 0.6953. So there's our correlation. And then with that, we want to write a brief description of the association. So we're going to describe the association between airfare and distance of the flight. And then with this, we need to go back to that number line. So let's take this 0.6953 and let's go back to our number line of negative 1 to positive 1. Now 0.6953, that is landing in here. And there's a 0.6953. So with that, what we're getting out is a moderate strength and a positive direction. So that's what we want to use to describe the association. So the distance of the flight is positive and moderate strength. So that's how we get our correlation and then use that to describe the association. Then coefficient of determination, That's relating to r squared. So we're going to take this 0.6953 and we want to square it, which is going to be a 0.4834. And with that, that's telling us this percent of variation in y that depends on x. So what we could say is 48.34% of the variation in y, which in this case y is the airfare of the flight. So of the variation in airfare can be explained by x, which is the distance of the flight. All right, so given data, that's how we can find the answers to most of these questions through GeoGebra.